Hello everyone, my name is Chris and I work for LA County Library. I think we can all agree, we're living in times of increased stress. I want you to take a moment and think, what happens to you when you feel stressed? What sensations do you experience? I know I tend to feel tense and sometimes have a rapid heartbeat. We all have a reaction to triggers and stress. I'm here to tell you a little bit about why we have certain reactions to stress and a few strategies that can help you when you're experiencing stress or anxiety. These strategies come from the Community Resiliency Model, created by the Trauma Resource Institute, a nonprofit organization focused on creating trauma-informed and resiliency-informed individuals and communities internationally. The Community Resiliency Model is a science-based system which focuses on the biology of the human nervous system. There are common human reactions to stressful or traumatic events that have effects on the mind and body. Since the model is based on human biology, it helps individuals and communities have a perspective shift. They shift from seeing reactions to traumatic events as human weaknesses to seeing them as a biological process. The conventional view is that people and their reactions to stressors are bad. People just don't care, and we need to stop making excuses for people. Someone with a conventional view might ask, what is wrong with you? There's been a lot of work in the past few years to move to a trauma-informed view. Someone with a trauma-informed view might think people are suffering and they need an intervention. And we need to learn how trauma impacts a child or adult's development. Someone with a trauma-informed view might ask, what happened to you? This model focuses on a resiliency-informed view. Someone with this view might think people are resilient. They need our compassion as they learn new skills. Any person can learn self-regulation skills based on science or biology. And they might ask, what is right with you? What are your strengths? Again, this model is based on the biology of the human nervous system. When we experience stress or trauma, our sympathetic nervous system is activated. This prepares our body for action. We experience sensations such as an increased heart rate, rapid breathing, and sweating. Conversely, our parasympathetic nervous system is activated when we are in a restful state. Our heart rate and breathing slow as our stress hormones decrease. By tracking these sensations, we can learn to identify when we are out of our resilient zone and use our resiliency skills to get back to a state of well-being. First, we must understand our okay zone or our resilient zone. This is when we are in a state of well-being, in mind, body, and spirit. When we are in our okay zone, you can feel mad or sad, but still function. We can describe this as a river of well-being. However, when we are triggered by a traumatic experience, we can be bumped into the high or low zone. As you can see in this diagram, when we are bumped into the high zone, we might be feeling edgy, anxious, or irritable. When we are bumped into the low zone, we might feel depression, fatigue, exhaustion, or numbness. Tracking the sensations we feel when we are bumped out of our zone can help us identify when we have left a state of well-being and need to use self-care skills to bring us back. The Community Resiliency Model includes 6 key wellness skills that bring the mind and body back into balance. These skills are simple to use and can be done without talking about the past. Reading and writing are not required, and they are good for all cultures, backgrounds, and ages. Today, we're going to discuss the first skill, called Help Now. Help Now is actually a set of simple strategies that can be used at any time for quick self-care when you're stuck in a high or low zone. They can also be used for both yourself and others. Next time you notice that you're feeling in a high or low zone, tense, anxious, irritable, fatigued, or sad, try practicing one of these Help Now skills. And if you notice someone else out of their zone of well-being, feel free to offer them one of these skills. Drink a glass of something liquid, water, juice, tea, coffee, whatever your preference. Notice the sensation of the liquid moving through your body. If you are outside, touch the surface of something in nature, grass, leaves, bark, flowers, whatever's around you, or in the environment, such as a building, wall, or pole. Look around where you are. Pay attention to anything that catches your eye. Really look at the details. Name 6 colors you see around you. Count backwards from 20 as you walk. If you're inside, notice the furniture. Touch the surface. Notice if it is hard, soft, smooth, or rough. Notice the temperature in the room. Is it cold, hot, or just right? Notice the sounds inside and outside the room. Describe what is causing the sound. Walk and pay attention to the movement of your arms, legs, and how your feet are making contact with the ground. Push against the wall or door slowly and notice your muscles pushing. Or stand against the wall and push your body back into the wall while you face forward. That's it. These 10 simple help now skills can be done anywhere, at any time, whether you're triggered in traffic or in your office. I invite you to stop and use one of these skills. Notice the sights around you. Notice the sensations you feel. And feel free to repeat any or all of the skills until you're back in your zone of well-being. Thank you for taking the time to listen and learn more about how to regulate your own personal well-being. I look forward to seeing you here again next week when we will be discussing the next skill, grounding. And of course, if you would like to learn more about the Community Resiliency Model, feel free to visit the Trauma Resource Institute at www.traumaresourceinstitute.com. Want to learn more or practice self-help skills on the go? Download their free iChill app available on Google Play and the iOS App Store.